वेलकम। इन दिस क्वेश्चन हैकर लैंड रेडियो ट्रांसमीटर वी हैव बीन गिवन एन एरे दैट रिप्रेजेंट्स विलेजेस विच आर लोकेटेड एज पर द गिवन एरे एंड दे मे नॉट बी लाइक मे और मे नॉट बी इन द कॉन्सिक्यूटिव टर्म्स हाउएवर देयर एग्जिस्ट विलेजेस विच आर नॉट प्रेजेंट हियर। सो इन दिस केस वी हैव अगेन के दैट इज ट्रांसमिशन रेंज like how much it has access or for how many villages it can transmit the tower, its neighboring villages, and after that we have the array which denotes what are the villages or like where are the villages located. So if I import this data to let's say paint and we have number of villages that is 5 and all are indexed from 0 to 4 and I have wrote down the elements here, so that would help us. So what will we basically do first is we will first highlight which are which numbers for which village is present. So for all these number a village is present. So by like common sense we can say that as range is 1 for this case, so range is 1, so what we can do is we can place tower here such that it can give access to its neighboring villages. This is the one case. Second case would be I can put tower here and that could give access to 3 and 5 as well. So with the help of 2 towers I can give access to all the specified elements here. So this is very simple case. So let me take the second case so I can explain you in a more detailed way and so we can move ahead with the coding. Okay, I have copied the data from the HackerRank portal. So in this question we have given array of size 8 and these are the villages where we need to provide the transmission, and the range of transmission tower is 2. So let me as we did in the previous example highlight the number of villages that are present in this case. So 2 is present, then 4 is present. So I'm highlighting these villages because we need to ensure that these villages get the transmission access. 6 is present, then 7 is present, then 9 is present, and I think 11 and 12. 11 and 12. So, okay, let's come to our solution. So, what we can generally think of is like brute force, let's say. So, we can assume that our tower has 2 range. So, if I put a tower here, that would ensure that this will give access to those first 2 villages. However, this is not mandatory because we need to ensure we give the access to the highlighted villages. So let's say you put tower here, this would give access to these villages. Then let's say you come at 7, you put another transmission tower, that would give access to these elements in to the 9, and after that you can put on 11 or 12 as per wish. So that would result into 3 transmission tower are required in order to provide service to all the highlighted villages. So this is a normal problem. So in order to get optimal solution we need to go with the greedy approach. So what we can do is basically we what we'll do in the greedy approach, we'll find the middle location. So let's say like we have range 2. So what we want from our program is we put the tower in the middle so we can give its access to both the neighboring condition, hence giving us the minimum number of towers. So what we can do in this case is what we can do, as I said earlier, is take a counter, let's say I, and will increase I till the middle position. So how we do that is we'll take a simple while loop. Let's say while I is less than given length, and in this case we want to do our operation. So we never want to build a tower beyond our length. So this is like base case, and in this what we do is we'll take another two condition. So I'll explain in the diagram first and then write the code. So what will happen is we want to find the village where we can build a tower. So we can find the village our desired village would be array 0 element and plus range. So this would give us the element where we can build a tower. So let me show you. So let's say our i starts from 0, and at the 0th index we have element 2, and we add range in that case, so this would become 4. Okay, so we are here now. So what we want is we get our village that is number 4. So after that we want to check the maximum value of I where we can get the village. So this would be so I can write another while loop. Let me clear this. While my I is less than that of length and my array ith is less than village. So I want to increment my I value, index value, until I get the desired village which I got from this formula. So this particular basically gives us the middle element or the maximum range, one side range. Let's say there is a tower gives us a range of 2. So we want to move element from A to B such that we can cover the maximum length. So let's say we have distance between A and B that of 2. So we want our tower to be built at 2 so it can influence the leftmost part, and we can look into the right part in the next loop. So after that we after this like whole complete loop, we want our tower to be right of this particular side. We don't want to build another tower in the same transmission area where B was built, so we would check the rightmost part. So this can be written as I'll show you that as well. So after that while we'll increment I, and this will give us the location like index of the element. So we can end it here. So after this the exact location would be given by, let's say, by array of ith value and one less value from that of our current I, because we have exceeded 1. So we can write this like this, and we can decrement I here. So that will help us in our next loop as well. So exact position would be I. So if we do the math, we were at 0, then we get into this loop. So we check village position. So array of 0th was 2 plus range, that is 2. So our village becomes 4, and we check for ith value which is less than or equal to. So this is less than equal to condition village. So for we know that at 1th index 4 lies. So this would be 1 count, and for 1 which is equal to the village, there will be another count. So I would become 2 in this case, and we are decrementing 1 from it, so it will become 1. Like here we are decrementing here, and the exact position for the tower will be array of I. So at array 1 would be the exact position. So we can check in our array at 1 position. There is a 4th number village. So we can build tower here, and this will cater our need to this villages. So 2 got covered and also 6 got covered. Okay, after this we want our tower to be built after 7, or like we want our tower not to be present in this range as well as this range, because this is again the minimum length which tower can cover from, like let's say let's assume that the array begins from here again. So so we can get the optimal solution. So we can do that similarly, like we did in this case. We got the middle village, so we can write the same, like we can repeat the code as it is. So let me take the different color. So this whole code can be copied once again here. So that will leave us with incrementing I to the, like, sorry. So our I would was 1. So our village in the next loop would become array of 1 position was 4 and range is 2. So we are looking at 6th village. So we, if we check I for the 6th, so it is 3. So counter would be 4 if you do the math. Okay, the code was becoming messy, so I wrote it down. So as I was saying earlier, so let me show you the whole example again. At first iteration here, we know that our I is 0. Okay, so let's assume I to be 0. Then it comes under here. So village location becomes A0, array of array at 0th element plus range is 2, and at 0 position we have 2. So village location becomes 2 in this case. Okay, 2 plus range 2. So this would become 4. After that, we iterate I until we get the village position. We got in the above statement. So for I is equal to 0, that is 2 less than 4, we increment I, that is 1. When I is equal to 1, element at first index is 4, so that is equal to the village location, we increment I again, so I becomes 2 now. Okay, outside we decrement I once, so that would leave us with I is equal to 1, and the value at first index would be the place where we want to build our first tower. So the question does not ask us to like print the where we want to print the tower, where like where we want to place the tower. However, this is for our own explanation. And after that, we would be as I told you earlier, we would be at this position, and we want to do the process once again. So we'll find the village location again. So that would be element at the first index. So that is 4, plus range. So 4 plus range 2 will be 6, and we'll increment I until we get which is less than or equal to 6. So in that case it would become 1, 2, 3, and 4. So I would become 4. Okay, and I is less than that of length, total length. So here I would be adding number of tower plus plus. So I haven't written here as of now, but okay. So after this loop, I would be having one tower. Okay. The next loop would start with I is equal to 4. And this is less than that of total length, given length, that is 8. So we'll go with the loop. So will becomes, so I'll directly write the values. So element at 4th position plus range. So at 4th position, element is 7 plus 2 would give us 9. Then we'll increment I until we get a 9th element. So I was 4 here, so it would become 5 and 6. So I becomes 6 in this case. So we are decrementing I once. So that would be the value where we would be updating our next tower. So element at the 5th index, the value at the 5th index in the array is where we are building the next tower. So at 5th index we have 9. So our next tower would come at 9. And this will cater the needs of these two villages, this and this. So if you can see, this is, there is similarity. We cater the needs of first 5 villages, and then we moved on to the next, and we use the same formula. After that, our I become, I think it was 5. So will become element at the 5th location, that was 9 plus 2, so it would give us 11. So I would iterate to 8. Sorry, not 8, 7. And after that, we would get our second tower. In third loop, we will be having I as 7. So that is less than 8, so it will go into the loop as I talked earlier, and after that our I will become element at the 7th position, so that is 12 plus 2, 14, and after 7 our will become element at the 7th position, that is 12 plus 2, 14. After that we'll iterate our I whenever get the position that is less than or equal to the village location. So we can loop it to the till the 7th, and after that we do not have definitive values here, so that would lead us to giving the value of I is 8, and after that we would be minusing 1 from array, so that is 7, and element at the 7 is 12. So this is where the next tower will go at 12, and this is for like single purpose. So it can give access to those villages and here as well. However, on the right hand side, villages do not exist. So after that, our I will become 8 again. So we'll iterate through loop and I will begin 8, and this is our third tower, and we won't be going into fourth case because our length becomes equal to the that of our I becomes equal to that of the length, so we won't go into the third loop. So this was the whole explanation for the scheme. So I'll write code in HackerRank portal. Let's check there. I'll start with adding library files. So in the explanation, I did not mention that we have not given we were not given sorted array, but I have converted that to the sorted array. So you can basically do using sort function. Let me complete the skeletal. Okay, skeletal is complete. So we know that we'll be given length of array, then we would be presented with the range. So we can take any length and a range as well. After that, for the given length, we can create array. Int we can create it dynamically, or you can directly initialize it, so it won't matter. New int length. After that, we'll use for loop to take input. For I is equal to 0, I is less than length. Or you can directly take vector, so you don't have to give the all the basic requirements. So let me go with the vector. So vector int array. I'll take one variable that is input to take input. So I'll take input same input, and we'll push back into the given vector. Push back, okay. After this, I'll sort array. Sort array dot begin array dot end. Okay, so up until this point, this is our like basic process, and after this only begins our code. So what we'll do is we'll first check our I, a new variable for this case, so we can initialize here as int I is equal to 0. So we don't want to take I from here. So when while I is less than length, we'll go into loop. First we'll check so let me copy the code from paint. I wrote from here, copy. So I have to initialize variables here. So let all tab. Okay. So this would become int village location. So this is not necessary, so I can comment it out. And I have forgot to add tower, so let me add it quickly. Tower plus plus, and need to initialize the variable to 0 in tower equal to 0. So need to put output, that is cout and number of towers. Okay, that will do. So let me once again check if I'm missing something. Seems to be okay. Okay, check for the code if it's working or not. Compilation error and not declared. Okay, so this is length. So here length as well. Okay, this passes normal test cases. Let's check for all test cases. I think I'm going to have a timeout. Yeah, okay, nice. Thank you. If you have any issue or if I was not able to explain it properly, do let me know so I can improve on my part.